Welcome to audio video system playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain Electret microphone in this session. So this session is all about Electret microphone, in which I'll explain Electret microphone in with respect to capacitor microphone. So to explain Electret microphone, these are my session outlines, where first I'm going to explain basics of Electret microphone, then after I'm going to explain structure of Electret microphone, then after I'm going to explain working of Electret microphone, and then we will see characteristics of Electret microphone, and at the end I'll sum up this session by explaining applications of Electret microphone. Electret microphone's basics. So see, when we talk about Electret microphone, so Electret microphone, that is a form of capacitor microphone. But as we have seen, capacitor or condenser microphone, that was very costly and that was unsuitable for field. And that is due to we were been having external bias in capacitor microphone. You can see that in my previous session, I have explained already. So capacitor microphone, that is costly, it is unsuitable for field as we need external bias to that. In Electret microphone have been introduced, where Electret microphone is even a capacitor microphone, but in that we don't need any external bias. So in Electret microphone, it is a capacitor microphone, but it has built-in charge. So because of it has built-in charge, we don't need any external bias. So in capacitor microphone, when you have been having capacitor microphone, 50 to 100 voltage that we need to give it to it. So it was actually unsuitable for field. While as if you have Electret microphone, you don't need that external bias, right? As we have some material, I'll explain you Teflon material that we have it in its structure, which is having built-in charge, and that built-in charge is been utilized to avoid external bias supply. So we don't use external bias here in Electret microphone. So let us see the structure. So structure is almost similar to the structure which is there with capacitor microphone, where you see here there is metal diaphragm and that is connected with spring. In capacitor microphone, there was backplate over here. So here even there is a backplate, but along with backplate, there is Teflon material. Now see, this Teflon material, that is having built-in charge, and that built-in charge is negative. You can see this is Teflon material with blue color, that is having built-in charge over here, and that built-in charge is negative. So as this built-in charge is negative with this Teflon material, this metal diaphragm that will be having positive charge. So this negative and positive charge will generate voltage. Now this voltage is actually V is equals to Q by C, and as V is equals to Q by C, that voltage is depending on capacitance. Now when sound is applying pressure over here, here built-in charge is constant, that Q is constant. As per sound pressure from here, this metal diaphragm will move like this. And as this metal diaphragm move like this, this capacitance C, that is C is equals to epsilon 0 epsilon R A by D. The value of capacitance C will change with the change in D. So when this metal diaphragm is moving inside, D will decrease, and as D decreases, C is equals to epsilon 0 epsilon R A by D, that will increase. And as this diaphragm move outside, this D will increase, and as D increases, capacitance will decrease, as C is equals to epsilon 0 epsilon R A by D. If D increases, C will decrease. And as we have said, like see, voltage V is equals to Q by C, where Q is constant. If C increases, V will decrease. And if C decreases, V will increase, and that will generate electrical signal. So this is how this complete structure is there, and that is how it will generate electrical signal. So this electret microphone, that is a version of capacitor microphone, but only difference is we have built-in charge, and that is what provided by having this Teflon layer over here. So Teflon layer is providing fixed charge, right? And because of that, we don't need any external bias supply. So this is about structure of electret microphone. Now let us see the working. Now see, insulating material, that is what Teflon material, which we are connecting it with black back plate, and it can trap large quantity of fixed charge and it can retain it for longer time. So it can trap large quantity of fixed charge and it can retain it for longer time. We don't need any external bias because of this Teflon material. Backplate is coated with thin layer of Teflon. That Teflon is negatively charged at a time of manufacturing, and this charge remain trapped for a longer period, and because of it has negative charge, on diaphragm there will be positive charge. So as this is having negative charge, diaphragm will be having positive charge. Now positive charge on diaphragm and negative charge on Teflon will establish electric field in a gap in between two plates. So this positive and negative charge will establish electric field, and there will be generation of signal V. So sound pressure will change capacitance, as we have discussed. Q remains constant, and same characteristic as capacitor microphone, but there is no external bias and less costly. So this is less costly as we don't need any external bias. Its working is same, its characteristic is almost identical to capacitor microphone. This is even capacitor microphone, but here we don't use external bias. So this is what the basic difference which is there in between electret microphone and condenser or capacitor microphone. It is sensitive to temperature and humidity, so which may cause leakage of charge. So this microphone is sensitive to temperature and humidity, and that may result into leakage of charge. So this is the basic working which is there with electret microphone. And we can use this microphone for lecturers as a clip microphone, right? And as a wireless mic in sports meet. So you might have seen this as a collar mic. For a lecturer, we can use this electret microphone, as well as this could be used for wireless mic in sports meet. Now let us see the characteristic. So first, as I have told, it does not need any external bias, as we use Teflon material, right, which is negatively charged, sensitive to temperature, it is sensitive to humidity. So we should not use this in high temperature region, as well as in humid environment we should not use it, otherwise this microphone may get damaged. Overall, it has very good frequency response, and we have already seen frequency response for capacitor microphone, so almost identical frequency response is there. But this is sensitive to temperature and humidity, and we don't need external bias. So this is what about characteristic of electret microphone. Now let us see the applications. So the first basic application, that is in small PA system for clubs and small halls, we can use this as a tie clip microphone for lecturers, radio microphone. As a radio microphone in sports meet, we can use it. So these are some applications which is so helpful to understand electret microphone. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you have understood this session, and I want you to give your valuable suggestions. The reason is I want all those things which is required to be solved here on my channel, and that will be helpful to students, those who are learning from my channel. As well as you will be finding, I have made one application
where you can download all this material which I'm teaching here free of cost. So you can access it free of cost from my application Engineering Funda. Detail of application that is given in description of all videos. So you can go there and from there you can download it on your Android mobile phone. So that is how you will be able to understand all those things in parallel with material.